Hello, I'm Ross Exton, and this evening we've come to the At-Bristol roof terrace outside the planetarium to give you our top tips for spotting meteor showers. Shooting stars or meteors can be seen when tiny particles of space dust collide with our atmosphere and burn up, blazing a trail across the sky. On any given night, several of these meteors can be seen every hour, and it's estimated that around 44,000 kilograms of material falls on the Earth every single day. These showers occur when the Earth passes through the huge trails of dusty debris left behind by orbiting comets, and are named after the star or constellation that is close to where the meteors appear in the night sky. For example, every August, the Perseids appear to radiate from the constellation Perseus and originate from the comet Swift-Tuttle, which orbits the Sun every 135 years. So to give us some top tips on spotting these meteor showers, I've tracked down At-Bristol's very own planetarium officer, Lee Pullen. Hello, Lee.
Hi, Russ.
So where is going to be the best place to go to spot these meteor showers?
Well, basically, you want to head away from the light pollution of towns and cities. And if you log on to a website called darkskydiscovery.org.uk, then you'll find a list of all the best places to go.
And what about lying on the ground? Is that going to give you the best kind of view of the sky?
Well, leaning back is obviously a good thing, but lying directly on the ground is a bad idea. And that's because the ground is going to get really cold and it will sap all of your warmth very quickly. So the best piece of equipment you can use is just a deck chair.
So is there any other kinds of equipment or anything like that you would recommend?
Well, you could always take a notebook and keep a tally of how many you see, and then you can compare these rates with observers from other parts of the world. If you're going to do that, I recommend using a torch with maybe some red nail varnish or some red cellophane over it. And that's because if you use a regular white torch, that will ruin your dark adaption very quickly. But a red torch will preserve your dark adaption, so you'll still be able to see those fainter shooting stars.
And is there any kind of activity or anything like that where people could take part in some real science with these meteors?
Yes, you can keep your tallies of how many shooting stars you can see, and then there are some websites that you can submit these answers to, and that will help us to produce more realistic zenith hourly rates. These are predicted peak rates of how many shooting stars people will see for a particular shower.
So when is going to be the best time to go outside and take a look for them?
Well, you might see some as soon as it gets dark, but if you're dedicated, then later is better. Really, the pre-dawn skies are the best. The longer you look, the better. You'll see even more when your eyes become adapted to the dark, and generally that takes around 20 minutes or so. So, more you look, the more you see.
So Lee, any final thoughts on spotting these meteor showers?
Meteor spotting really is fairly simple. You don't need binoculars, telescopes or any other specialist equipment. Just head out into the countryside, away from the light pollution, have a nice clear horizon without anything in the way, and then look up.
So there you have it, nice and easy. Go outside, look up and be amazed.